Hi, I'm Doug DeMuro.
And I'm Tyler of Hoovie's Garage.
And this is Hoovie and Doug Talk About Cars. This is a show that we're doing where we talk about cars.
Right.
It's pretty simple. We're doing it in front of a cloak.
Yes.
And pretty much just going to be chatting about cars for a few minutes every week or every 2 weeks or something. I don't know. And you can see all of the cars that we discuss in the description below. We've got links to all of them on Autotrader, so you can go and buy the vehicles
yes.
that we are telling you about. Okay, today we're talking about cars that we want to own the most. Cars that we physically want to possess the most.
Yeah, and usually I just go buy them.
This doesn't stop you. There's no want, you just do.
I have no impulse control and any kind of restraint. I just go and buy it if I want it.
If you had serious money and you got $100 million.
Ooh.
And what would you go and buy then?
Well, I don't know. $100 million is a little unrealistic, but just in my, like, something attainable.
I realize that it's unreal. That's the point of this.
Well, if I worked really hard one day, I mean, SLS.
Really?
I like the SLS so much.
Yeah. With the doors or the convertible?
The doors. But mostly because of the engine.
Yeah.
The last 6.2 or 3, whatever you call it. Yeah. They always round up with AMG.
That thing growls.
Man. Yes.
That's a serious car.
Yes.
Also some of the best handling of any exotic, even
yes.
though it's like that big front engine thing. I was very surprised.
I love it. I like it a lot more than the deep V turbo thing going on with what AMG's doing right now. And they're not depreciating. That's why I think if I owned it,
yeah.
that I could spend $150,000 on a car and it won't drop. It's done depreciating right now.
It's weird. They haven't
yeah.
really lost. They lost a little at the beginning, kind of came back up, but they never really, there was like the Z, like they never really went that far down.
Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't buy the cheapest Bugatti Veyron in the country?
Yeah.
That would be a great video.
That is true. That is true. It just doesn't do much for me, I guess.
Really?
Maybe because it just seems like it's a car that's so unattainable that I just like.
You know, it's got 1,000 horsepower.
Yeah, I know it's got 1,000 horsepower. It also looks like
a what?
Like it belongs on my 600-pound life, you know, that reality show. It's,
that's a cool car.
It's porker. It's a porker.
It's a cool car. That's a cool car.
It's a little weird.
Yeah, but you got
like
$100 million. You have a $100 million budget here.
Okay.
You're like, oh, I'd buy $150,000 SLS because I won't lose anything.
So you could buy like
what's wrong with you?
like a 10-year-old. So what's a $1 million Ferrari right now? And then Enzo's $2 million.
Million
more.
Bucks for Ferrari. There's like the vintage. Some
and F40 is still $1 million bucks?
F40 is a little more, but yeah. Would you get one of those?
Over a Bugatti, I would think.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, you can get $100 million, you can have both, but yeah. So you'd rather have an F40? I'd rather have a F50 than both of them. F50
okay.
is my all-timer.
Great.
It's the most exotic.
I don't even know if I've ever seen one.
Yeah. No one has. But people
right.
see F40. They made a buy. Okay,
yeah.
The answer, let me tell you what I think.
Cars that I would most like to own. Number one, BMW 1 Series M. You remember that car?
Yes.
I would give anything to have one of those.
They are really cool.
Except the $55,000 that they cost, apparently, because I haven't bought one. But I love that car deeply.
Is that more than what they were new?
Yeah. The MSRP was like 49. They're still selling forever because they're the best.
Wow.
They're one of the best cars in our modern era, that car, in my opinion.
Okay.
Carrera GT.
Yeah. You want to die?
No. We're gonna edit that out.
Okay,
that's not gonna be part of this.
Okay.
Carrera GT. Carrera GT
yeah.
is the greatest supercar ever made.
Okay.
The last
Why?
Great supercar.
Why?
Because the last stick shift, no stability control. I mean, that was the last serious supercar.
But it's so powerful and still analog that it's super dangerous.
Yeah.
As we've
no,
seen.
I wouldn't drive it that much. I would get a yellow one, which was the best color. They only made 40 in North American yellow. I'd get a yellow one. And I would park it in my house, and I would bring people like you over, and I would say, I have a Carrera GT. And then you'd be like, well, this guy's serious. This guy's legit.
That's what you want to do with cars. You don't actually want to drive
No, I want to drive every other car,
wealth.
But I'm scared of the Carrera GT.
Yeah, everybody's scared of it. You want to look at it and not use it.
Yeah, pretty much. That's
okay.
That's pretty much how it goes.
Huh.
No, I would drive it a little.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't drive it faster than like that.
Yeah, I think most of mine go old. I don't know. I just tend to go, like, my dad had a 930 turbo.
Yeah.
And I just love that car.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's one that's attainable. I feel like if I work really hard, I can go get myself a
930. Yeah. Although those could get more expensive. I remember when I 6 years ago, I was looking at a 930. It was like $40,000.
Mm-hmm.
Those days are, I assume, long gone.
Long gone. Yeah, my dad bought his 6,000 original miles in 86 for $40,000. He sold it 5 years later for $60,000, right before I reached driving age, where I never got to drive it.
Which is probably good, because you wouldn't be sitting here today.
What
are the... What are they selling for now? What's a nice 930 going for now?
About $100,000 for a decent one.
That's a lot of money considering.
There's some way, you know, there's like my dad's 6,000 original miles would probably be way more than that.
930. So your number one was SLS. When I say car you most want to own, the first thing you think is SLS.
Yeah, I guess just Mercedes guy.
What
yeah.
if you had a family?
If I had a family?
You got a kid already, but what if you had
right.
four of them? You know, Toyota Sienna. Again.
Well, then you would have multiple cars. I mean, I have
okay.
16 and a half right
vehicle?
Now.
What is your family vehicle if, you know, you have infinite money?
Infinite money. Well, you want a Bentayga, oh. right? He texts me every 5 days about a Bentayga.
I do text you a lot about Bentaygas.
Yes.
You know, the thing I like about the Bentayga is it's got a 12-cylinder engine with 600 horsepower.
Right.
It's a serious car. I saw one of those on the road the other day. There's no one I'm more jealous of than people who are driving around in Bentaygas.
Mm.
Do you disagree with me?
They just don't jump on the page for me. It's not. I'd rather have a Cayenne what? Turbo.
Oh, that's...
I already have one.
That's wrong. That's not correct. What your family vehicle? Your family vehicle. You'd get a Cayenne Turbo. Is that a?
But I can't. Like I, my brain just doesn't work that way. Like all of a sudden I have all the money in the world and I would go buy a Buick Park Avenue just because that's just what I can't help myself.
You're not gonna carry your kids around a Park Avenue if you got $100 million. You're gonna be like, Daddy, why are we driving this piece of crap?
Maybe.
No, you're not. That's not.
I'd have the nicest one, like 5 miles. On
so
it.
If you had, the answer to this question for you is, if you had infinite money to buy whatever, you would continue buying the kind of cars that you buy.
I would continue to buy crap.
But in really good shape. You'd buy like the nicest.
Correct.
Instead of I bought the cheapest whatever, you'd buy like the nicest used.
I would spend $100,000 on like a 5 mile Buick Park Avenue that somebody just drove off and put in their shed after the
showroom
floor.
Those are always interesting. You see those come up on Autotrader.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, what's the deal? You know, like you see like a Buick. Or an Elante with like 1,000
right.
miles.
Like a Mercury Marauder or
right.
something. Yeah.
And it's like, how did this transpire? And sometimes it's not even cool cars. Sometimes it's like an Accord with like 19,000 miles.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. It's weird because obviously the Elante and all that stuff, people think it's going to be an investment. They put it away. They put it in a carpeted area of their garage
right.
and like wrap it and all that stuff. It's the weirdest stuff. But yeah, why do people
so,
yeah, why
but
do you buy
so
an Accord?
You buy all these things and you'd like make a museum out of...
Exactly. A hoopty museum, yes.
The 1 Series M, I would hope, is something that you would consider for your
Sure, museum. Sure. Yeah, yeah. I mean, BMWs, me and BMWs haven't had a good history.
If I had a family and I was buying any car, I would get a GL63. You know that car? GLS63,
mm-hmm.
they call it now.
Okay.
It's got like 1 million horsepower and a lot of seats.
And you like that over the new G?
Yeah, I'm not going to get a G-Wagon. It's not, it doesn't
it's
have
not practical.
Seats. It's not practical.
How many kids are you planning on having, Doug?
Well,
the
no,
world would like
to
know this, probably.
Explain to me how this works. Okay, you got to get a car with like 30 seats because their friends come.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, my mom had an Isuzu Rodeo, and we didn't have enough seats, and so I literally rode in a cargo area with no belt on. That was not safe. Mm. You can't do that anymore in today's world.
Yeah, but if you're going to do that, then you just go buy an Escalade. You get a General Motors full-size SUV.
Because
you have $100 million, you would just have a stretch Escalade or like a Sprinter Airstream or something like that. And just like, well, we have
okay,
this.
So you would specialize your cars. You'd
yes.
get like an Airstream Sprinter and you'd get an SLS.
What I do right now.
Park Avenue.
What I do right now.
Okay,
yes.
Okay, you
yes.
just have a long list.
Every
of
occasion is covered. Why do I have one that can cover everything in a mediocre fashion when you can have 20 that do the one thing perfectly,
there.
Right?
Okay, that's reasonable. That's reasonable.
Doug, you only listed one car. Your 1M
Career
and your...
Career 15 1M and GLS 62.
Oh, three? Okay, you did three. I'm sorry.
Doug is properly considering the Park Avenue Ultra.
Ultra. The Ultra.